We all want beautiful websites that reflect our brand and actually convert visitors into paying clients or customers. The question, though, is what website platform is going to help you do exactly that? What's up, friends? My name is Davey of Davey and Krista, where we help you build brands and websites, generate more leads, and grow your business. Today, we are chatting about Showit and Elementor, and we're comparing those two platforms so that you can make the decision on what platform is best for your business. Before we get started, make sure you hit that subscribe button so that you don't miss any future videos. And if you have a request for content you'd like to see in the future, drop that in the comments below this video. All right, let's get after it. If you're not familiar with Showit or Elementor, Showit is a modern website builder that was built specifically for photographers, but has been adopted by any business that wants an easy-to-use platform to build a beautiful website. Showit is going to be comparable with website platforms like Squarespace and Wix. They're going to provide the website building tools you need to actually design your website, and they're also going to become your website host. One advantage of Showit versus something like Squarespace or Wix is that it's going to integrate with WordPress. More on that in a second. If you're looking to get started with Showit, you're probably looking at a subscription that's going to be somewhere in the ballpark of $20 to $40 a month, depending on the plan that you choose, plus the cost of your template if you decide to purchase one. Elementor is a WordPress page building plugin that makes it easy to design a stunning WordPress website. You get all the power and flexibility that comes with WordPress. You can choose your own WordPress host, and you get the drag and drop simplicity of Elementor. You can get an Elementor license for as little as $49 a year, but keep in mind you'll also have to find a company to host your website as well. All right, now on to some of the more significant differences between these two platforms. Let's first talk about ease of use. We're big believers that the best website platform for you is the website platform that you feel comfortable updating your website on. Showit has a drag and drop editor that feels a lot like the Adobe suite. So if you're a creative, you'll probably feel right at home with Showit. Elementor also has a drag and drop editor. However, you're going to have to deal with the complexities of WordPress. With WordPress, though, there's just a little bit more to it, and things aren't always exactly where you would intuitively go to find them. All things equal, if you lack technical experience, then you'll probably find Showit a little bit easier to pick up. This point goes to Showit. All right, let's talk about something that's important these days and something that we really shouldn't have to mention, but we'll get into it anyways, and that's mobile responsiveness. Any website builder that you use should be mobile responsive. If it's not, that is definitely a sign to move off of that website platform. Fortunately, both Showit and Elementor are. What's cool about Showit and something that sets it apart from a platform like Squarespace is that you can build a design that's specific to mobile. The downside, of course, is that you actually have to go in and design the mobile version of your website. It's not all going to just click into place based on what you did on desktop. Elementor provides a little bit more flexibility than Showit in that you can design a desktop, tablet, and mobile version of your website. And one additional benefit is that whatever you do on, let's say, the desktop version of your website would automatically be responsive for mobile. Yes, there's probably a little mobile formatting that you're going to have to do, but in general, things click into place. And of course, you'd want to optimize your Elementor website for mobile, but it's kind of nice that a lot of the heavy lifting is already done. While both platforms are mobile responsive and look great across mobile devices, there's probably a little more flexibility on Elementor. All right, let's talk about design flexibility, what many of you are probably most interested in. First things first, check out the description for this video. I'm going to include a link to the same design, one website designed on Elementor and one website designed on Showit. And what you'll see is they look very similar. And one of the reasons that we love both of these platforms is that we're able to achieve the look and feel that we're going for. However, we're typically able to build a design faster in Showit than we are in Elementor. And that makes sense because Showit's focus has always been around creative freedom, and they really do make it easy to design beautiful websites on their platform. So while you'll be able to see that we can easily build a design in both Showit and Elementor, it's easier to do so in Showit. So point has to go to Showit in this category. Let's chat SEO and optimization. Like I mentioned before, Showit integrates with WordPress. So if you have a blog, your blog is going to be on WordPress. What's awesome about that is that you're going to be able to utilize WordPress plugins that are going to make things like SEO that much easier. If you're on the advanced blog tier of Showit, you can pretty much choose from whatever SEO plugin you want to use, whether that's Yoast or something like Rank Math, which is what we recommend. If you're on the basic blog plan of Showit, you still get access to the free version of Yoast. Something that's nice about Showit is they take a lot of the technical complexity out of running a website. You don't have to worry about setting up hosting, server settings, anything like that. You don't have to worry about caching and CDNs. They take care of all of that stuff. You really just have to worry about creating great content and doing some on-page optimization. However, all things being equal, WordPress is a little bit more optimizable. Is optimizable a word? WordPress is a little bit more optimizable than Showit because you have greater control over your website. Now, with that said, that might be another reason for some people to use Showit, because you don't want necessarily more control over your website because maybe you get overwhelmed with the technical stuff. And a company like Showit is going to take care of things like setting up a CDN and caching, all these things that you would have to do on your own if you had a WordPress website, or at least hire somebody to do for you. So keep in mind that just because you have more control over something doesn't mean that you're necessarily better off. But if the technical side of websites doesn't bother you and you're looking for a little bit more control, then WordPress Elementor is probably the more optimizable route. So that point has to go to Elementor. All right, so what happens if you get stuck and you need some support? Fortunately, there's lots of support out there for both Showit and Elementor. Elementor has an active Facebook group, and depending on what license you buy, you could potentially get access to priority support. Anytime we have emailed their support team, they have got back to us in a reasonable amount of time. Showit, however, has an active Facebook group, and they offer support via email and live chat. Showit support team has a great reputation for getting people the help that they need. So if you think you're going to need more support, then Showit is probably the better option for you. So which platform is better? Well, unfortunately, that's a lot of personal preference. I know, but we love both platforms. There's a reason that we've decided to build specifically on Showit and Elementor. If you're looking to design a beautiful website, but some of the technical complexities of managing a website really sound overwhelming to you, then Showit might be the best option for you. If you want to design a beautiful website and a technical challenge or two doesn't sound all that overwhelming to you, then Elementor might be for you. One thing that we didn't talk about in this video are e-commerce businesses. While you can definitely run an e-commerce business on a Showit website, and there's people out there that do that, we've typically found that Elementor and WooCommerce are a better fit for e-commerce businesses. So if you're running an e-commerce business, then you might check out Elementor. And you don't have to start from scratch with Showit or Elementor. Check out our shop. There's a link in the description below to check out our lineup of stunning Elementor and Showit websites that are perfect for really any business. All right, there you go. That's everything you need to know to feel good about your decision between Showit and Elementor. If you have any additional comments or questions about Showit or Elementor, make sure you drop those in the comments below this video. All right, that's it. Be sure to subscribe and like this video so that you don't miss any videos in the future. Peace.